This is the most perfect ring galaxy ever found. Now, most galaxies fall into three broad categories. Spiral galaxies with distinctive spiral arms like the Milky Way, elliptical galaxies, which are basically just massive blobs like M87, and irregular galaxies, which are, well, irregular. But there are a few special galaxies with an almost perfect ring-like structure around their cores, like this one, which is known as Hoag's object. And this was the first ring galaxy ever to be found, and it has the most perfect ring structure of all the ringed galaxies. It was first spotted by astronomer Arthur Hoag in 1950, and in the 55th volume of the Astronomical Journal, he wrote,
"This object, which appears to be a perfectly symmetrical planetary nebula, was discovered on a 75-minute Jewett-Schmidt plate. A perfect halo, 17 arc seconds in radius, surrounds a diffuse central image. Its position, size, and nucleus are not typical of the planetary nebulae. The halo, which is bluer than the nucleus, does not show an emission on an objective prism plate that records the central object. As a most conservative alternative, one might say that this is a new species among the pathological galaxies. Other ring-forming mechanisms, such as a diffraction effect or a gravitational lens system, are less probable explanations. The mass of the central object, in the latter case, would have to be on the order of 8×10^11 solar masses. Since the object is unique, I suggest that a proper identification would be a worthwhile short-term project."
Oh boy, was he wrong in that last part, because the origin of this ring-like structure in Hoag's object has been hot debate for 7 decades. In 1985, astronomer Noah Brosch suggested that this ring-like structure could have formed from a resonance similar to how ring-like structures form in spiral galaxies that have a bar-like structure at their centers. But there's a bit of a problem with this suggestion, because no bar-like structure was found at the center of Hoag's object, so that can't be the case for this ring. Another proposed explanation for the presence of this ring came in 1987 from Schweizer et al. They proposed that this ring could be the result of a direct collision or a close encounter between two galaxies that happened around 2 to 3 billion years ago. Now, this would be promising if they had also found other telltale signs of galaxy mergers and interactions, like tidal tails, but they didn't. Also, in this recent study, the team found that the average age of the stars in that outer ring is less than 2 billion years old. So if these stars all came from a galaxy that crashed into the yellow blob in the center 2 to 3 billion years ago, how can the average age of those stars be younger than when the collision occurred? Doesn't quite add up, does it? In this same study, the team proposed a new hypothesis. They suggest that Hoag's object formed some 10 billion years ago via a monolithic gas collapse. They suggest that the yellow core formed first, with the ring forming shortly after via the accretion of gas surrounding the yellow core from the intergalactic medium, and it is now in a stable formation. However, they do stress that more observations are crucial to put better constraints on this particular formation model. So really, there's still a lot of mystery surrounding Hoag's object some 70 years after it was discovered by Hoag himself. Also, in case you didn't notice, there's another ring galaxy hiding in the distance between the gap of Hoag's object. What weird space object do you want to explore next? Drop your suggestions in the comments.